Good evening. This is Strange Love, and I'm your host, Cami Chaos. Welcome, babies. Good evening, and welcome to a very special, very live, very tech version of Strange Love. I'm your host, Cami Chaos, and as always, I'm joined by Dr. Normal, Mr. Chaos.
Hello.
And tonight, we have Craig Schwartz, the president and CEO of Toonlet. And if you don't know what Toonlet is, you're about to find out. Hi, Craig.
Hi. Hey, everybody.
So,
how you guys doing?
Good. How are you?
Good. Good.
Yeah?
Going into, you know, long weekend. Got to enjoy that.
Mm-hmm. You're going to spend a lot of time with your new Wii toys?
I really am. In fact, that's why I'm only doing half an episode. People coming over for Mario Kart and Rock Band.
Very, very cool. I do not have Rock Band, nor do I have Wii Fit. And I don't know enough to be upset about the Mario Kart, but I'm sure I'd be upset about that too.
They're all very good. Although there's a lot of cheap plastic involved.
Yeah. Well, that's the thing with video games these days. So, do you want to tell us what Toonlet is?
Sure. It's just free software tools, online tools that let anybody make their own webcomic blog, regardless of their artistic ability. So we have a couple different tools. They're actually sort of one tool is embedded in the other tool. There's just a little place where you can kind of put together comic strips, and you can open up a character editor from there and put together characters from parts and mix and match different noses and eyes and hand gestures and different things for them to hold and things like that. And when you've got the character the way you want it, you just give it a name, save it, and then you can actually change the parts around and create different expressions, moods, and poses and things like that. And create a library of those to then use in your comic strip.
Where did the idea for Toonlet? Because I don't know where I picked it up. I've heard that there's been a little bit of tension between the actual car. You know, there's the people who actually have the talent and skill to create a cartoon, and then there's you who give me. Who does not have the talent and skill it takes to make a cartoon, suddenly I have magically the talent and skill it takes to make a cartoon and stick it on my blog anytime I want to, which I love. And I'm just wondering if there is any friction with that.
So far, if it has been at all, it's been rather minimal and subdued. Some of the places that I showed it to early on were kind of a little skeptical, just in the fact I showed it to a comic publisher. This was, I guess, about 6 months ago. We really didn't have a full product then, and they kind of saw that it maybe had some potential, but they were a little bit worried that it was kind of like giving anybody the power to do what any of their artists can do, and you know, in the right hands, you could do a lot with Toonlet, but there are still a lot of tricks that an artist has at this point that I guess kind of I don't think it's they should really view it as a threat. But our goal is to definitely get to parity with what you see in a typical comic strip, and hopefully eventually an actual comic book or graphic novel down the line. But that's going to take some time. I don't think that they should sweat it just yet.
Don't have anything to be afraid of yet.
Yeah, and in fact, you know, the online comic artists, you know, some of the web comics people, they, you know, we're going to try and actually work with them and let them put Toonlet on their site to sort of power forums and things like that. So I think there's a lot of actual ways that Toonlet can be beneficial to their talents as an artist.
So
just need to build up stuff.
Did you become involved with Toonlet from the aspect of, are you a developer or a cartoonist or a little bit of both, or...?
I'm more a developer, I guess, although I don't have any really hard tech skills, but yeah, I kind of veered off into producing several years back, and I know just enough to be able to sort of talk to the people who are actually going to build it. But I guess you could say that it was actually could it be a Toonlet began its life, I guess, as a video game. It was I'd left EA where I was working, and we were going to make a game that was actually surprisingly a lot like Rock Band, except it was kind of like if Rock Band was done how Toonlet's done. We're kind of going to make it a little open-ended and let people make their own songs rather than sort of play a video game over somebody else's songs. Mm-hmm. And we got about 2 months into it, and it was we were really just trying to build a demo so that we could put together money, get investors to actually build a real product. And we have some interesting code that powers that stuff, but it was definitely slow going. Very soon, I sort of hit the wall in terms of development because I was actually doing a little bit of coding for that. And I just started to draw because we had this idea for this one feature. So I just started to draw these little parts and built together a little prototype in it that would kind of grab some of these parts and build a face. Mm-hmm. And it worked. I didn't actually think it was. We were kind of looking at it, thinking about it, and it became clear that that was a much more realistic product for us to build. So we kind of switched gears and moved to Toonlet. That was how Toonlet was born.
When did you start it? When did it first make its appearance on the web?
Oh gosh, our first actual strip. I can actually look that up right now. I think it's the middle of August of 2007. So let me go back to that right now. It's actually August 15th at 6:17 a.m. and we were, that was, I guess, like the first time we probably had an actual working registration system. So we've probably had like a month or two of maybe strips that could get created that didn't really go anywhere or do anything.
Well, see, you're kind of coming up on your 1 year birthday.
Yeah, I guess so. I mean, we were closed off to the world. It was just sort of me and Seth, the other two, and the founder, and a small coterie of friends who were kind of checking out the service for us and making sure we weren't doing really, really stupid things. Kind of using it and tell us what they thought. And I think, it was really just this past January that we actually started to get any real measurable amount of traffic when Read White Web linked to us. Mm-hmm. And we've just been kind of trying to grow slowly and organically ever since then.
So where did you get the art? So you go in and you select all these, heads, and who are the artists, or how do the artists contribute?
Well, it's really whoever I can cajole or convinced to actually build an art pack. We have Sarah Alexic, who is an artist around town. She's done a couple of really cool indie self-published stuff, and I believe she's working on a graphic novel now. We have another artist, Surly Ben Bittner, who both of these were friends of mine. I just met them over the course of my time in Portland, and knew that they could draw, and knew that we needed art, so talked them into it. The 8x8 ninja pack that's on the site, that's actually a little boy, and he liked Toonlet and wanted to make his own pack, so he made a little pack of ninjas for us.
Very cool.
And Josh Kemble, I think I met at the last Stumptown Comics Festival, and Peter Bagg, I actually did a little work with when I was at EA, a little comic.
And you just posted a new pack just recently, right?
The variety pack, which was literally cobbled together from just people that we could convince to actually do a page of template art for us at three different conventions that we went to. So it's very mix and match, and it isn't necessarily as coherent as say like Josh Kemble's pack, where you'll click the random character button and get generated something that's definitely kind of a cohesive character. But you sometimes have to manipulate the variety pack a little bit more. But it's definitely got a lot of variety.
I haven't played much with the variety pack, and in case anyone doesn't know, I've kind of become a Toonlet addict in the last, I don't know, few weeks. Miss Burroughs did a toonlet on her site. She's in the studio right now and pointing at herself angrily because I forgot initially. Oh, yes, angrily. But ever since then, I've just had to have my fingers in the toonlet world. And I just started playing with the variety pack last night before I went to sleep. So.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
What? So I guess actually this is it's a good opportunity for me. What are the things you like and don't like about toonlet?
I will tell you. Well,
I like this feature, by the way. Have the special guests ask the questions of the host. So thank you very much for that. That's,
I like it when my guests have questions. I really do. It's really my favorite
ask
thing.
Cammy show, you know.
Well, the first thing is that my cousin today told me to tell you that she wants animals.
Ah, we've heard that request before.
She wants animals.
I think we have a pack coming up in actually about probably the next couple of weeks that does feature a goodly amount of animals.
Oh, good. She was trying to make a cat. She had a very difficult time with it.
Yeah. I've seen a few other attempts at cats, and none of them really quite hit the mark.
We'll definitely
work on that.
I'll tell you my favorite feature, and then I'll tell you what could use a little work. My favorite feature is... that once you make the character, it's made and you can do anything, you can change it, and you get the library of personalities and attitudes, and you don't have to ever go back and remake the character. Because that's the only thing that's ever took any time for me to build it was building the individual characters.
Mm-hmm.
And then once they're built, you know, you've got the world of options. You can give them a martini, you can give them a cupcake, you can give them
devil ears.
Devil horns, yeah.
Devil horns, I'm sorry. Which is a prominent feature of your toonlet.
Yes, my toonlet has the devil horns, unless I'm being particularly nice. But I think, and this probably, you may already know this, it doesn't seem that there's a help section or a frequently asked questions section.
Yeah.
Because.
Okay, we'll get on that.
Yeah, I've had people ask me now. And I've told them, you know, to the best of my ability, the biggest thing is how do I get the two-column format? So I always have to go back and tell them how I get the two, because you were nice enough to email me and tell me how to format it and then how to format my blog so that it would work. But I don't think that once you guys take off and become super Toonlet popular, you're going to have time to email everyone individually.
Well, we're certainly trying to do it now, but yes, that would probably save everybody a whole lot of headache.
I really appreciated the help, but let's see. So this is the big Portland question. If it's not bacon, then it's OpenID. Do you guys have any plans to support OpenID at some point? I have to ask, or I'll get in trouble. You do.
I know, and Miss Burrows is right there, and I know Treasurelicious uses OpenID, which
yes,
I was actually happy to see.
Exclusively.
Yeah. And I was surprised because I got right in on the first try. I figured I would input the wrong something wrong mm-hmm. the first go, but I got it. So yeah, to answer that, yes. And there are a lot of questions, a lot of features that we will answer with a yes. Mm-hmm. We want them definitely, and OpenID is something that we definitely want. But it's just a two-person team, and things move kind of at a slower pace than I think either of us would like. So it's one of those things where I think actually we're going to be pretty heads down on a feature for most of the summer,
mm-hmm.
and small changes to the site as we need to, and. Mm-hmm. And it'll probably be late in the summer before we can really start addressing, like going to war with the feature list that we have
mm-hmm.
and trying to check all those things off. So yes, but I cannot say when.
Okay.
Unfortunately.
Fair enough. The fact that you want to do it is lovely. I think Mr. Chaos has a question.
Oh, yeah, I was just wondering if you ever heard back from Michael Arrington.
Oh, that was my next question, babe.
Yeah, you know, I have not yet, and it was sort of a poor timing because I think a lot of people are away for Memorial Day weekend, but I don't know. I filled out a Crunchbase. I applied to Crunchbase, which is the TechCrunch registry of startups, and I actually got to use it, it said. Throw important links in this section, and I actually got to link back to TechCrunch. So I'm hoping that maybe does that, because Dion Allmayer, who has the blog Allmayer.com, that's Almaer, which I guess is a technology blog of it seems like it's fairly well known in tech circles. He made a Toonlet comic which got linked on TechCrunch and the Twitter blog this past week. So I'm trying to get a little publicity from that.
You've had a little more media love. Martin pointed out to me earlier that you guys were in the newspaper.
Did we actually make the print newspaper?
Did they make the print? He doesn't know. He's giving me horrible information.
Okay, the research department.
He said something about Pop Sugar and USA Today. We should really pay our people. Pop Candy.
Pop Candy. It's a USA Today blog. I actually don't know whether or not whether or not it's in the print edition, but we hit that about a week and change ago, and got a lot of traffic from that.
Craig, I think you need to go fire your media communications guy, okay? <You're big. laughs>
But then I'd be out of a job.
Exactly.
Well, you know, what are you going to do? So I have a question, and then I have a couple of questions from other people. Your mom has started talking to you in Toonlet. Is it fun to have her involved in what you're doing? Is it fun to have her? I mean, do you enjoy that? Is she happy? And what does she tell people that you do when they ask?
You know, actually, I think she's pretty proud of me right now because she actually uses it. So she knows other times, you know, for years that she'd always have to kind of dodge the question of what I did when people asked because most of the time she didn't really know. Mm-hmm. But like now she goes on to Toonlet, like she knows how to make comics, she knows how to explain it. So I think she's kind of happy with her son right now. But I mean, it's great to see her on there, but it's also you run the risk of when your startup is little more than the founders and their parents that run the risk of lapsing into parody, I guess. But I definitely appreciate her having her strips on there. She seems to get a kick out of it.
She does seem to be enjoying it from what I've seen.
So
we have another question. Which was, did you get in trouble in class for doodling as a child? That was from Miss Burrows.
I did, actually. Yeah, all the time. Then I just started sleeping in class and that got in trouble for that, too. So it was, I actually had aspirations. I wanted to be a web, or not a web comic because there weren't web comics back then, but I wanted to be a comic book artist growing up. And it was around 20, 21 or so, and I tried drawing a couple of pages, and it was just a lot of work. So I think I got about 2 pages into a comic story that a friend and I wrote years ago and abandoned it after that. So maybe I'll need to go and revisit that with Toonlet.
Very cool. Well, we're getting close to our half hour mark, and I know you have friends coming over to play Wii, but do you want to tell everyone where the site is, and is there anything else you want to let us know?
No, I think that's everything, unless you guys have any more questions. But the site is toonlet.com. It's toonlet.com. And go there.
We have 2 more questions. We just have 2 more questions. Gunfighter wants to know if you can give a Toonlet tattoo, and I've told him that there's the one tattooed model. Which I've used. There's the tattooed torso.
Oh, yeah.
But he wants to know if you can give a Toonlet tattoos.
That's another feature. Like, we'd like to sort of break out. We're working on a background builder right now, so you'll be able to assemble backgrounds up from parts.
Oh.
And our goal in the future will be to do the same thing with torsos. So you'd be able to build sort of your torso up from parts, choose different collars and things like that. So I guess tattoos could definitely fall into that category, but that's another one of those things that we would love to have, but we have no real time frame for getting it.
Before I found the tattooed torso, I played around with adding the Zazz and changing the size of it on top of the skin, and it worked, but you could only get one tattoo. And then Miss Burrows has another question, and it is, she wants to know why all of the breasts are either saggy or really large or non-existent. I think she just wanted to get me to say breasts, but
I've heard that question in various forms too, and You know, it's tough. We don't put any real, like, we never really asked our artists to deliver certain work. It's just kind of whatever they give us, we accept, and it's sort of, we want to go forward with that. And for some reason, that's just what's come back to us. So we've had a lot of people ask about either the lack of breasts or the shape of breasts and why they're not shaped like this or less shaped like that. it's how they came to us.
So, I was wondering about that. So when an artist draws these elements and you have to somehow create the scaling, or is that done on the fly, or?
You scale your own.
Oh, you scale it.
Yeah. Sorry to answer for you. You have scaling control in your tune.
Yeah. So there's a default scale, but you can scale it up or down depending on you know, what you need as an artist, as a tuner creator.
Gotcha. Just seemed like it's probably a lot of work. I mean, you get these things on paper, right? And you have to scale them in your application or something, or figure that out. I mean, there's got to be some pretty cool secret sauce behind the scenes, right?
It's you know, pretty straightforward. We just sort of run a little production process that converts it from bitmap art, you know, scanned art into vector technology, which lets you, you know, scale it up or scale it down without any loss of resolution. And we're still sort of working out the overall kinks in how to do that, because our end goal is to really let anybody upload their art. You know, so if you wanted a particular prop for your character to hold, or Zaz to, you know, like you were saying, use his tattoo, that you'd be able to just quickly sketch that and upload it to us and add that to your own pack down the line. But right now that's still a little ways off. I guess it is worth noting, though, that you can make your own art pack, like Aiden did with his ninja pack. There's a link at the bottom of every page that says "Make an Art Pack," and if you click that, it'll take you to a little page that with terms of service, which are pretty permissive. All work is the creator owns it. We just license it from them, and we have a little template file that you can use to kind of sketch out what, you know, all your various art, and then send it to us, and we will turn it into a pack.
Very cool.
I'm so downloading that.
That is so cool.
Yeah, we need to give that a little more play, because we definitely, it's so much fun to get packs from people.
So where do you see this going? I mean, it seems to me that this thing is so much fun, and you know, it's like, what happens when Toonlet becomes Twitter, right? mean, are you ready for that? Or,
well, that's sort of the plan. We, you know, right now we're bootstrapped. We haven't taken on any investment, so we're just kind of running it on the fly, seeing what happens, trying to do it as cheaply as possible. Obviously, we would love to have Twitter-style success. We hope for it very, very fervently.
Without all the crashing, though.
Without all the crashing, definitely. That we'll just have to kind of play it as it comes. But our long-term goal for the site is to really sort of be something that be a comic book publisher. I mean, we want to, you know, have people be able to put their assemble all their collected Toonlet works into their own comic books and graphic novels. And you know, we want to be able to offer people shirts and hats and mugs and things like that with their Toonlet characters on them, and greeting cards and all other things. So
I know someone will be the first buyer.
So you can't see me. We're live streaming right now. Oh my gosh! Hello, me.
She's waiting.
I need it.
Yeah,
T-shirt with my Toonlet on it.
On that. We're working on the ability to actually add the Toonlet tools to your blog, so the Cami Chaos blog and the StrangeLove blog would be able to add actual Toonlet to your forum section, so people would be able to respond to your topics with comic strips and use the tools right on your site.
That's the other thing I forgot to mention. I love that you can reply in Toonlet.
Oh, thanks.
In Toon form. I think that was a stroke of brilliance.
Thank you. It's one of those things where we need to actually get a sizable audience, I think, before we're going to start seeing real use in that. But occasionally you see some we've had some surprisingly deep conversations take place in just in comic strip or ply form. It's really kind of exciting when that happens, when it just goes on for a couple different pages and, you know, talking about philosophy or simulation theory or something like that. So definitely strange. And it's those moments where you feel like, huh, maybe this is, you know, something a little bit more than the sum of its parts. This could be bigger than just making comic strips. It's, I guess, blogging 2.0, maybe.
Yeah.
You're looking for a buzzword.
Wow.
We've also heard it referred to as strip blogging.
Strip blogging. I like that. Yeah. It has horrible connotations that I love. Well, we really appreciate you coming on the show. We were absolutely thrilled that you were going to come on, and I really wish you all the luck and success with Toonlet, because it is just so much fun and easy to
Thank
use
you.
And fun.
Yeah,
Thank
absolutely.
You so much.
Thanks a lot. This was wonderful, and Toonlet is great.
Thank you. Thank you guys for having me on. I really appreciate it, and thanks for using Toonlet.
Oh, no problem. Have fun tonight.
Thank you. I will. Take care, you guys.
All right. Bye-bye, Craig.
Bye-bye.